Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today's topic is going to be one kind of transformation of sentences. This is a very important topic for class 9 and 10 mainly. Even in class 11 and 12 you will have to solve this transformation of sentences. And one important part of these transformation of sentences is degree of comparison. When we read in class 7 and 8, we are given to remember words like the degrees of the adjective, the adjective which we have to remember, what are the positive forms of the adjective, what are the superlative forms of the adjective, the comparative forms of the adjectives. So later on in our class 9 and 10, we are given to form sentences without changing the meaning of the sentence. We have to change the positive sentence or the positive degree into a comparative degree without changing the meaning of the sentence. We will move on to that, but first we will study the basics of it, a little bit of the basics, and then we will move on to the sentences. First, there are 3 degrees of comparison. We all know this, that there are 3 degrees of comparison: the easiest, positive degree, comparative degree, and the superlative degree. What are we talking about over here? We are talking about the basics. The first few lines would be just the basics. So in these 3 degrees, there are something which must be followed for each of these degrees. For example, in case of positive degree, what we have to provide, we have to put as. Whenever we are stating something in a positive form, for example, I am as good as my brother, I am as naughty as my brother, we are putting as before and after the adjective. What is the adjective? Good, bad, naughty, intelligent, all these are adjectives. Before the adjective and after the adjective in a sentence, we use the word as. For example, Rama is as good as my brother. So in this sentence, we see that good is the adjective, and before good and after good, we are using these two words, which is as. This identifies it as a positive degree. Before the adjective, we put as. After the adjective, we also put as. In the second sentence, again, naughty is the adjective, and before after it we have put as, and before it also we have put as over here. So this is the rule in case of positive degree. Next, we will move on to the comparative degree. In the comparative degree, it is very important to put than after the adjective. Just after the word, after the adjective, we will have to put than. For example, if I am comparing myself with my brother, for example, if I say I am not as intelligent as my brother, this is in case of a positive degree. But if we have to write it in a comparative degree, then I have to say I am more intelligent than my brother. Okay, so we are using the word after the comparative form. That is, more intelligent is the comparative form. After that, we are using the word than. See, for example, Rama is better. Better is the degree, is the comparative degree. After that, we must put than. This makes it a comparative form. We are comparing one person to the other person, one thing to the other thing. Whenever we compare, we have to put the word than. So, second sentence, Seema is naughtier. We are stating that Seema is a naughtier person than my daughter. So, we are comparing Seema with my daughter, and Seema is the naughtier one. So, while comparing the two people, we use the word than. This is another important thing. In case of positive degree, we put as before and after the adjective. In case of comparative degree, we put than after the adjective. Next, we will come to the superlative degree. This we will just look into it, and we will not go into detail because this is a very basic thing that we have already done. Superlative degree is what we always use, the, because superlative form means the best or the worst, the supreme quality. So there should be only one, isn't it? The best or the worst, these categories are only one of a whole kind, isn't it? The best. So we will put the before the adjective. For example, Rama is the best boy, Seema is the naughtiest girl. These words, naughtiest and best, these are adjectives which show somebody of the extreme quality. Isn't it? The best or the worst or the naughtiest. So before that quality, before that adjective, we will have to put the. That's all. Next, we will move to the main thing. If we are asked to change the positive degree into comparative degree or superlative degree, we need to remember that the meaning cannot be changed when we are changing one degree to the other in a sentence. When we are given a sentence and we are told that you have to change it into, maybe the sentence is a positive sentence, positive degree, and we are told to change it into comparative degree, we cannot change the meaning. We have to keep the meaning same, but we have to transform the sentence. Okay, so for example, we are coming to kind one. There are three kinds. If you understand this, it would be the easiest of all. See, kind one. I am as good as my brother. I am stating that I and my brother both are same. Both of us are good, isn't it? Neither my brother is better than me, nor I am better than my brother. We are of equal qualities. So now we are told to change it into comparative degree. We have to compare between me and my brother. However, both of us have the same qualities. So how can we compare? We cannot compare, isn't it? I and my brother have the same qualities. We are both equally good. So we are told to change it into comparative degree. That is why we have to use the word not over here, because none of us are better than the other, isn't it? We are both of the same quality. That is why we will say my brother is not better than me, because none of us are better than the other. That is why we have to use the word not. Okay, if we see that both the two things or two persons in among which we are comparing, between which we are comparing, if both of them are of the same quality or same capability or same standard, then we cannot use or compare the two. That is why we will then have to use the word not. This is very important, first kind. Next, we move to kind two. Now we will read something like a mathematics problem. See, we are told that there are 50 children in a class. Now, a teacher takes a test on grammar. A test was taken on grammar. Now, Raj Lakshmi, one child, got 50 out of 50. There is a child in the class called Raj Lakshmi. She has got 50 out of 50. Okay. Nobody other than Raj Lakshmi got 50 out of 50. Nobody. There was not even a single child who got the same marks as Raj Lakshmi. Only Raj Lakshmi got 50 out of 50. So she is the best. We can say Raj Lakshmi is the best student of the class in the superlative form, because nobody is better than Raj Lakshmi. So she is the best. Next, if we are told to change this sentence into a comparative sentence, then there should be two sides, Raj Lakshmi at one side and on the other side, what should be there? There should be no other student, because none of the student is as good as her, isn't it? That is why on one side we have to keep no other, and on the other side Raj Lakshmi. In the positive degree, we will say no other student is as good as Raj Lakshmi, isn't it? So we have to understand that this best, this quality, this is the adjective best. So this is the superlative form. Now, if we are told to change it to positive form, then we have to write good, and before and after we have to write as it was told, as good as. So now on both sides, one side will have Raj Lakshmi obviously, and the other side, what should it have? It should have no other child, isn't it? No other student is as good as Raj Lakshmi in the class. Number three, Raj Lakshmi is better than all other students. Now we are told to compare, comparative degree. Then we have to use better. And beside better, we have to use the word than, because it is a comparative form. So better than. Now Raj Lakshmi is better than how many students? All the other students, isn't it? So we will have to use all other students. So we have to remember over here that in case of this type of a sentence where we are given a sentence where we find that the girl is the best of all or the supreme of all, isn't it? There is no one like her. Then we will use words like no other, all other for comparative degree and positive degree, isn't it? Raj Lakshmi is the one of a kind. If this is the whole class and if Raj Lakshmi is one child over here, among 50 students, nobody else is like her. That is why in those cases, in such a case, in the positive and comparative degree, we will use no other and all other. Okay, this part is clear. We will now move to the third kind. Before moving into it, we will see some other examples for the kind number two. Superlative degree, the sentence is, Amit is the tallest boy in the class. So this is the superlative form, the tallest. So what should be the drawing be like? This is the number of children in the class and this is Amit. This person is the tallest. Nobody else is as tall as Amit. That is why in the positive degree, we can write that no other word, as we have read in the last case. Remember, no other and all other. So over here in the positive degree, we are using no other boy is as tall as Amit. In case of comparative degree, if we are told to start with no other, then we can write no other boy is taller than Amit, same way. Or we can also write if we are told that you have to begin with Amit, you have to start the sentence by Amit. So then we can place it in this manner that Amit is taller than how many boys? Amit is taller than all other boys. No other boy is taller than Amit. That is why Amit is taller than all other boys. In the remember portion you have studied that we use all other or no other in case of a sentence where we have stated that one person or one thing is the best or the supreme of all. Okay, there is nobody else like him. This part is clear. Now we will move on to the last kind. Again, we are given another sentence, another mathematical question. It is quite like the kind number 2. Again, there are 50 children in the class. Again, there was a test taken and Rajlakshmi got 50 out of 50 again. But in this case, Rakesh has also got 50 out of 50. Another boy has also got the same marks. In the previous case, in kind number 2, we found only Rajlakshmi got 50 out of 50. There was nobody else like her. But in this case, Rakesh has also got the same amount of marks. Now, we cannot say that in this class, only Rajlakshmi is the best. Because Rakesh is also there, isn't it? There is another boy who has got the same marks like her. So, I cannot call Rajlakshmi the best, isn't it? So, how will we write the sentence then? We will have to use this thing for superlative degree. We have to write Rajlakshmi is one of the best, isn't it? She is not the only best. She is one of the best because there is another one like her. So she is one of the best. In case of superlative degree, you must remember that we have to write one of the best. We have to use one of extra. Next, see, now we have to see the comparative degree at first. We have to compare. So we must use which word? Better than. Isn't it? We will use better than. Now it has two sides. We are doing the comparative form. That means we are comparing between two. One side Rajlakshmi is there. Other side what would be? Rajlakshmi is better than all other? No. Because again we know that Rakesh is also there. Isn't it? We cannot say over here that Rajlakshmi is the best. So what we will write? We will have to write is better than most other students. See, among 50 children, Rajlakshmi is one, Rakesh is the other. So two children have got 50 out of 50, but 48 other have got less than them, no? That is why Rajlakshmi is better than most of the students in the class. Rajlakshmi is better than 48 other students in the class. So most of them, isn't it? That is why Rajlakshmi is better than most other. This part is clear. Then we are coming to the positive case. In the positive case, we have to write as good as. We have to use as good as. Now how we will state this sentence? We can write few other students. Isn't it? Only there is only one person. Only one child, Rakesh, who is as good as Rajlakshmi. Isn't it? So we will write over here few other students or very few students are as good as Rajlakshmi in the class. Only a few number of students have got marks like her. That is why we can write few other or very few students, anything. So in this case, what we will remember? In this case, we will use few other or most other. Okay. In the previous case, in case number 2, we used all other and no other. In case number 3, we will use few other and most other. That is all. Now we will see another example over here and then we will finish the class. See, in this case, in the superlative degree, Amit is one of the tallest boy, isn't it? So let me draw the diagram again. Amit is one of the tallest. That means this one is Amit. There is few other boys who are as tall as Amit. Okay, Amit is not the only boy who is the tallest of all. Okay. So we will use this one of in this case, because there are a few boys who is as tall as Amit, we will use one of. Comparative form, you have to use taller than. Amit is taller than almost all, but not everybody, isn't it? There is one or two boys who is as tall as Amit. So in this case, we will not write Amit is taller than all other boys. We will write Amit is taller than most other boys. And in case of the positive degree, we will write that very few boys are as tall as Amit. In this class, maybe there are 40 boys, and among 40 boys, 3 boys are as tall as Amit. Okay, so very few boys are as tall as Amit. Among 40, only 3 are as tall as Amit. Isn't it? 2 are as tall as Amit. That is why very few boys are as tall as Amit. But in comparative degree, Amit is taller than how many boys? Most other boys? Almost 37 boys. Amit is taller than 37 other boys. Okay, so that is all. We have to remember these 3 cases. And if you remember these 3, you'll be able to solve all the sentences, transformation of sentences on degrees of comparison. Okay, I hope you have liked the video. If you have liked it, please like and subscribe. Thank you so much, children.